Parapsychology, created by the Centre of Excellence, narrated by Jane Branch.
Centre of Excellence, Parapsychology. Module 1, An Introduction to Parapsychology. What is parapsychology? Parapsychology is the study of paranormal phenomena involving the human mind. Para is from Greek and means beside, closely related to, beyond. The term parapsychology replaced psychical research to indicate the shift towards experimental methodology and academic discipline. The phenomena studied includes telepathy, precognition, clairvoyance, mediumship, psychokinesis, near-death experiences, reincarnation, ESP. The intention is to use a scientific and scholarly approach to study anomalous phenomena, anything that is out of the ordinary or defies explanation. Parapsychology is often identified as a pseudoscience, partially because it has become associated with a variety of fringe topics. A misconception is that a parapsychologist is a psychic, and many people use parapsychologist as a synonym for a psychic entertainer. Research has unveiled a high level of fraud in studies, both on the parts of the subjects and the researchers. In addition, badly designed experiments and researchers' lack of familiarity with stage magic tricks have brought discredit to the field. The scientific community regards paranormal phenomena as having naturalistic explanations, resulting from psychological and physical factors that give the impression of paranormal activity. Psychologists have reported that phenomena such as mediumship, precognition, and out-of-body experiences can be explained by psychology without recourse to the supernatural. Others believe strongly in the existence of psychic phenomena and seek to provide evidence to support their beliefs. A further sector of investigators simply regard the phenomena as worthy of investigation. However, the term skeptic within parapsychology is most frequently applied to those who seek to debunk studies and displays of anomalous phenomena, assuming that there is always a naturalistic explanation. The implications of the existence of psychic phenomena, often called PSI, are wider-ranging and suggest that what science knows about the nature of the universe is incomplete, especially in terms of space and time, and the transmission of energy and information. The capabilities and limitations of human potential have been underestimated, and there may be additional, as yet unexplained, methods of sensing the world around us. Assumptions and philosophical beliefs about the separation of mind and body may be incorrect. Our understanding of the nature of perception and memory may be incorrect. Assumptions about the divine nature of miracles may have been mistaken. PSI phenomena address many philosophical problems, including the role of the mind in the physical world and the nature of the objective versus the subjective. There are spiritual impactions, as personal PSI experiences are often accompanied by feelings of profound meaning. Parapsychology is controversial for a number of reasons. Many people, including the media, confuse parapsychology with sensational, unscientific beliefs and stories about the paranormal, leading a number of scientists to dismiss the field as unworthy of serious study. Much of the evidence produced by institutions is difficult to access, as it's published in limited circulation professional journals. Some people are afraid PSI might be true and therefore oppose investigation of it. A brief history of parapsychology. Although the word parapsychology dates back to the mid-17th century, it didn't come into popular usage until the late 19th century, when it was used by psychologist Max de Soir. Prior to the 18th century, there were few systematic studies in relation to anomalous phenomena, although early literature includes many discussions about such things as apparitions, divination, dowsing, healing, and poltergeists. Often these are discussed in the context of religious belief, demonology, and witchcraft. However, there are accounts of a few investigations. For example, in the 12th century, Gerald of Wales wrote about several ghosts in his Journey Through Wales. He also mentioned small, glowing balls of light, associated in Welsh culture with the spirits of the deceased. In addition to recording such accounts, he visited locations and spoke to the people affected to obtain accurate information. 17th century. The 17th century is often viewed in terms of the scientific revolution. However, the new methods of thinking and inquiry that developed were also applied to the study of psychic phenomena. An early pioneer of such studies was Francis Bacon, author of Novum Organum 1620, which pioneered the scientific method. Amongst his interests were direct mind-to-mind contact, precognition, and other phenomena that today would be called psychic. Saint Joseph of Cupertino. An example case is that of Saint Joseph of Cupertino, 1603 to 1663. He exhibited various psychic phenomena. For example, he was reputed to be aware of the thoughts of penitents and know if they were not fully honest during confession. Joseph was also said to have the power to heal the sick, but he was most famous for bodily levitations. There were numerous eyewitness accounts of Joseph's flights, the first of which took place in his hometown of Cupertino, during an outdoor procession on the feast day of St. Francis of Assisi. Joseph flew over the crowd, after which he fled to hide in his mother's house. From then on, Joseph experienced uncontrolled fits of bodily levitation. It was reported that on one occasion he flew from the middle of the church to the high altar, about 40 feet, and remained there for 15 minutes before descending. During another levitation, he ended up in a tree, and after coming out of his trance, was unable to get down until a ladder was fetched. On several occasions, he carried someone else up with him, holding their hand or hair. Investigated by the Inquisition in Naples in 1638, Joseph was cleared of any wrongdoing. The Royal Society. The Royal Society was founded in 1660, and a number of its fellows were not only interested in psychical research, they also engaged in investigation. Some of their work attracted criticism, a notable figure in this context being Robert Hooke, but the eclectic approach of the society permitted studies to continue. Those active in parapsychological research included Robert Boyle of Boyle's Law, philosopher Henry Moore, archaeologist John Aubrey, geologist John Beaumont, and Isaac Newton, whose interest in alchemy was shared by many leading fellows of the society. Another fellow, Joseph Glanville, was confident that spirits existed and interacted with the material world, and urged the society to investigate the world of spirits further. He collected and compiled reports of supernatural phenomena, and his most famous case was of a phantom drummer at a house in Tedworth. Glanville was one who argued that the evidence for the existence of ghosts should be judged without bias, being guided only by the evidence. However, growing impatience with older magical thinking led to a preference for what we would know today as hard science, based on careful evaluation of empirical data. There was also concern among psychic investigators about their personal reputation. A growing materialistic current was promoted, notably by Thomas Hobbes, who saw the world as a mechanical system, and he took part in developing a restrictive worldview no longer able to
accomplish. We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.